The Affin Pinscher is one of the least common pedigree breeds and is a small, amusing character with a big personality. One look at the Affin Pinscher is enough to understand why this dog is sometimes known as the Monkey Terrier. Indeed, Affe means monkey or ape in Germany, where the breed was developed initially as an offshoot of the vermin hunting terriers that were kept in great numbers by farmers and shop owners. The breed's charm and endearing looks meant that these dogs became sought after as pets, particularly by the well-to-do ladies. To this day, these little dogs enjoy being in constant contact with a doting owner. Now without further ado, let's jump right into our list of top 10 interesting facts about the Affin Pinscher. Number 1. Their origin. The early history of Affin Pinscher is somewhat unclear. Although Dutch artists of the 15th century did depict small bearded terriers bearing some similarity to today's breed, clear written evidence of standardization does not emerge until the 19th century. The Affin Pinscher is not classified as a terrier, but was originally bred to work like one. Their job was to exterminate rats and other pests in German stables in the 1600s. Eventually, Affins were brought indoors to rid the kitchen of mice. In time, they became dual-purpose dogs, ratters by day, and by night, devoted bed-warming companions for the lady of the house. The exact ancestors of the breed are still unknown. Some believe that these dogs may have been crossed with pugs, smooth-coated German pinschers, and a dog known as the German Silky Pinscher. Clubs devoted to the breed sprung up around France and Germany in the late 1800s, and the American Kennel Club welcomed these guys into its ranks in 1936. Today, Affin Pinscher-type dogs have contributed to the development of other breeds, including the Brussels Griffon and the Miniature Schnauzer. It's easy to see their relationship when you look at their rough coats and bearded faces. Number 2. Their physical characteristics. One cannot help but smile upon seeing an Affin Pinscher. Their head and face resemble those of a small monkey, such as a marmoset with a small domed skull, a flattened face, and a short level muzzle. The breed has lively dark eyes and ears that can range from dropped to erect. Most Affin Pinschers also have a slightly undershot jaw that accentuates their monkey-like appearance. Their coat is rough and harsh and is around 2 to 3 centimeters long over most of the body, although the underside of the neck, chest, and abdomen may have slightly longer and finer hair. The tail is carried upright with a slight curve toward the back, and both the fore and hind limbs are moderately angulated to lend power to this toy-sized breed. Number 3. An Affin Pinscher is a quintessential big dog in a small body. Though the German name for the breed reflects their appearance, it is actually the French who were closest to the mark when they dubbed the breed the Diablotin Mustachu, or the Devil with a Mustache. These little dogs are amusing, not only in their appearance, but also in their tough guy attitude. Affin Pinschers are lovable rogues, full of mischief and self-confidence. They hold themselves in high regard, and they do not take well to being treated or handled unkindly. If you forcibly try to cuddle Affins, well, they're most likely to bite you. And although very loving and affectionate with their owners, they're stubborn little dogs, and if understimulated, they'll find ways to make a nuisance out of themselves. This breed combines a clown-like charm with a bold nature, and their creative thought process will never cease to astound and entertain people around them. Number 4. They make great watchdogs. Sturdy, smart, and alert, the Affin Pinscher is an excellent watchdog who fears nothing. They're naturally very protective of their territory, and they tend to be suspicious and fearless of strangers. They also take their duty to guard home and family very seriously, and they won't hesitate to alert the entire neighborhood if someone is approaching the front door. These dogs are not normally loud, but they are easily excitable. So once your Affin is on alert, it'll take a while for them to calm down. However, the breed's characteristic fearlessness can land them in trouble, as these big dogs in a small body will not accept playing second fiddle even to far larger dogs, and will not back down in a confrontation with anyone. Affin Pinschers need to be controlled to ensure that they don't bite off more than they can chew. Number 5. They're known to make people laugh. Affin Pinschers are funny characters, and that's part of their appeal. Who wouldn't laugh to see these toy dogs walking on their hind legs or wagging their eyebrows and acting like they're the kings of the world, right? Well, their monkey-like facial expression with a beard also lends an air of comic seriousness. And they live up to their monkey terrier name, not just in looks, but in accent too. Affins are terrier at heart, inquisitive and bold, but they also love to monkey around, being playful and mischievous around the people they love. These little dogs have a great sense of humor and are best with a family that likes entertainment. Does your Affin make you laugh as well? Share your story in the comments below. Number 6. They don't like small children. While Affin Pinschers are known for making their people laugh, they're not the best breed for a household full of small children. Despite their humorous antics, they don't get along with kids very well. These dogs particularly don't tolerate rough housing, unwanted squeezing or hugging, and if they can't escape, they'll defend themselves by growling, snapping, or biting. So Afins are not naturally inclined to like children who may try to love and cuddle their pooch as part of the fun. But they are loyal to the adult family members and can be a great companion for a family with older children. Number 7. The trick to training them. Standing less than a foot tall, Afin Pinscher approaches life with great confidence. The breed has an undeserved reputation as being difficult to train because these sturdy terrier-like dogs are independent and can be stubborn. The truth is that these guys are very intelligent dogs and are generally eager to please the humans if they bond really well. Afins see themselves more as your friends than dogs, which is why this is not the breed you train, but befriend them. Training sessions also need to be fun and cooperative, much like a play session with plenty of rewards for small accomplishments. Keep in mind that they are easily bored and they tend to lose interest during long training sessions, so shorter, more frequent sessions can be quite fruitful. Number 8. Their ideal living and care. The Afin Pinscher is a perfect dog for apartment living if you have neighbors who don't mind the occasional barking. These are only moderately active dogs, so short, brisk walks or a suitable length of playtime is enough exercise for them. Also, they're really small, and so they should be full-time house dogs with occasional access to a fully fenced backyard when supervised. These dogs won't hesitate to confront animals much larger than themselves, an encounter that could easily result in mishaps. You gotta make sure that you keep them within your compound at all times. Number 9. Grooming them is an easy task. Afin Pinschers require fairly little grooming. The breed's coarse, shaggy coat is easy to maintain, with the main challenge being to keep it free of mats. You can brush and comb them weekly to accomplish this goal. Stripping is also necessary, but only once or twice a year to optimize the quality of the coat. This involves pulling dead but retained hairs using a special stripping comb. It can also be done by a professional dog groomer, or you can learn the technique and do it by yourself. With their undershot jaw, Afin Pinschers are sometimes prone to dental disease, and so daily tooth brushing is also recommended. If your Afin does not wear the nails down naturally, you can also trim them once or twice a month. Number 10. Their health issues. The Afin Pinscher generally enjoys excellent health with few significant concerns in the breed. Anisarca, an uncommon condition, is sometimes seen in Afin Pinscher pups, where abnormal amounts of fluid accumulate under the skin and within the vital organs of newborn pups. The reasons for its development are unclear, although some experts have suggested birth trauma as a possible cause. Another disease to be aware of is patellaluxation, also known as slipped stifles. This is a common problem in small dogs like Afins, which causes lameness in the leg or an abnormal gait, sort of like a skip or a hop. So before you buy or adopt one of these dogs, you should expect to see health clearances from Orthopedic Foundation for Animals for hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, hypothyroidism, and from the Canine Eye Registry Foundation certifying that their eyes are normal. And also, don't forget to take your Afin for regular health checkups for their better overall health. Alright folks, that brings us to the end of our list of top 10 interesting facts about the Afin Pinschers. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you already own one of these adorable dogs, let us know about them in the comments below. Please give it a thumbs up and share the video if you liked it. For more interesting facts and different dog breeds, click on our channel and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in the next one.